It is understandable why we do not know much about the ocean's floor. It is expensive and dangerous to go deep down. But mapping it will render much useful data, from navigation and fishing to mineral deposits and even the movements of tsunami waves.
For too long now, we have treated our own oceans as a forgotten frontier. It's time to change that, because our oceans have an incredible amount of wealth and resources, and they truly, truly are a very fruitful frontier.
Using information collected by scientific and commercial vessels, as well as manned and unmanned scientific submarines, the project named Seabed 2030 will create a detailed map of 190 million square kilometers of ocean floor deeper than 200 meters. The project is led by Japan's philanthropic Nippon Foundation and the non-profit association General Bathymetric Chart of the Oceans, or JEBCO. It is also supported by the United Nations.
The United Nations has adopted a resolution to have a decade of ocean science for sustainable development, running from 2021 to 2030. And during that decade, I'm very confident that we will have totally mapped the floor of the ocean.
Parallel with this initiative, the nonprofit Foundation X Prize challenged researchers and inventors throughout the world to develop better and cheaper technologies for mapping the ocean floor.
One of the reasons that we don't yet have a good map of the seafloor is it's a very expensive proposition. So a big portion of that are the ships and going to sea. So we really pushed, and all teams are now going to and are deploying from the coastline.
Another benefit from this project will be the knowledge gained about the final resting place of many sunken ships, including the possible location of the Malaysia Airlines jet, which disappeared in 2014 while flying above the Indian Ocean. George Putic, VOA News.